had familiarity with alcoholism, and so you know, I sort of understood addiction a little bit to the extent that I could in my role in it and what I would have to do. And so I literally, because I know how to stay present in the moment, and you know, I just had to do that every day, and every day I had to do the best that I could, right?
Right.
Seek out help and support, which is a huge thing that people need to do no matter what, and then just keep doing the best that you can and not enabling the situation, which is the hard part. Right. So that was that was the really tough part. And then afterwards, you have to get okay and comfortable with the fact that you did the best that you can, and you can't go to the past, the woulda, coulda, shoulda. Mm-hmm. You know, it's critical not to pull the past right now to where I am right now, because it's gone, right? And it's finished. And I did the best I could, and, you know, I have to be comfortable with that. And some days it's easier than others. Don't get me wrong. You know what I mean? Like today's a good day, right? So, but, you know, tomorrow, you know, I could go get a little wave of it and, you know, rethink it a little bit.
Right, because I think things like guilt and grief come in waves. But it's a matter of continuing to know what you believe, know what you've decided. And I love the fact that you tried your best, and there's only so much that you yourself can do, and it would have to, you know, it rests in the case of your husband. And so, I mean, but how do you get through the grief when those waves come? What keeps you steady to go through the, because I'm sure there's waves, like we just said, and what keeps you steady on your feet? Because there's somebody, like I said, a listener out there that maybe has lost her husband and she's grieving today, and she needs to know, how do I hang on for another day? Because I'm sure you lose part of you when that person goes. And so what do you have to say to that person out there that's maybe going through a hard day right today?
Well, you know, I heard a beautiful analogy about death, and that it's like an ocean. So you think about death as an ocean, and when you're bound to somebody via a relationship or marriage or whatever, right, when that person passes away and goes into the ocean, you've got to go in. You're in, right? So you're in up to your knees or your thighs or whatever, right? Because that person you were bound with, you know, bound to in your relationship, is in there. And so what I like to do visuals like that, so it helps me. Then I was like, okay, if I have to stand here for a little while, I have to be careful. So I make sure every day that I anchor myself back, like put in an anchor. And because I feel like each day, for whatever it is, why 24 hours a day makes such a difference, but each day I anchor myself every single morning.
What kind of routine do you have to anchor yourself in the morning?
So I just kind of take control over my morning first thing. Like, I don't look at my phone. I don't do any of that nonsense. I take care of myself, and I focus. You know, focus is key, right? What are you going to focus on? I focused the day he died, the day before he died, all that. Every day I would write five things that I'm grateful for every day. That's literally.
Wow.
After I get my water, and then I get my coffee's key, of course, you know. But after I do that,
we know coffee.
Right. You know how I am with the coffee.
Get your coffee, and then you sit down and write five things that you're grateful for.
Yeah, and it has to be something new every day. So you can't go the same thing over and over and over again. So, yeah, that's tricky, right?
I like that.
Yeah. And if I put a person down, I'm, like, really, you know, because now it's been many years that I've done that. Like, I'll put something about, like, if my daughter does something, but I'll say why, what about her? Like, what characteristic or thing that she does that makes me feel grateful, right? Not just for my daughter. You know, I make it a little bit bigger because it has to be different every day, right? So,
Right.
And when you do that, when you do that, the trick is you're going to run out of stuff. I mean, really. You do after a while, or you think you do. But so then you start looking at the, you say, well, I have to because it's the rule. So if something icky happens that day or the day before, like somebody's annoying the crap out of you at work or something, I always then can say, thank you for the opportunity to practice patience at work. So I'm able to actually turn even these icky things around because of that very simple, seemingly benign tool of writing those five things
right.
down.
Right. Now, I love that because a lot of times when I think of writing, you know, five gratitudes down, I get like, oh, no, I'm stumped. I wrote that yesterday. And so they have to be new. And in order for them to be new, what's kind of cool is that you saw, like you said, a sticky situation, and you made that into a positive, what could be positive about that. And I think writing the gratitudes with that little rule in there opens your eyes to what there is out there to be grateful for, and it takes your eyes off of the pain of maybe grieving.
Yeah, well, and you know, I had somebody that came in to me. She was like one of the first people in my door. And I always like feel like she's my surrogate mom in this area. My mom didn't at the time live here, but she said to me, she whispered in my ear, and she said, look for, and you know, she believes in God. So she said, look for God. He's going to be here. He's going to show you. Just always be on the lookout. And it's the same thing sort of with the gratitude thing. Always be on the lookout. Not only can you change your perspective on things that aren't so great, but you can be on the lookout because you're going to look where your eyes are pointed, right? So I have to, I'm looking for good things now, you know, because I have my little gratitude list, right? And it's it seems subtle, but it is so powerful. I can't tell you what an amazing change it is. Yeah.
I know. It is amazing. It's amazing. So I love that, Loretta. So in your grief, for those of you that are out there, write down five gratitudes each day, but they have to be different every day. So I sometimes would get stumped. I'd go, well, I'm thankful for the beauty outside. I'm thankful. But you're talking about deeper, going a little deeper and really being thankful for grateful for things that maybe our eye doesn't perceive at first. And then I think you're training a muscle is what it is you're training a muscle to see the gratitude. That is beautiful. So you know what? I love that. So use that tool, everybody out there, and you don't even have to have experienced grief to use this tool. That is wonderful. And I tell you, I can attest to it changes your life when you start being grateful for things.
Yeah,
so. Anyways,
well, the other thing I was going to add, Lorraine, excuse me, but the other thing I was also going to add, and it's been very effective with some of my coaching clients, is that literally if you're having trouble with one of your relationships with somebody, write five things you're grateful for about that person every day.
Good.
It changed everything, like literally everything.
I love it. It's huge. Okay, well, our time is almost up for this call, but I'm so glad you're going to be back with us next week. Let our guests know how they can get a hold of you and what you'd like to offer them today.
Well, I would love for you to come by and visit my website. It's Loretta Brooks, my name, .com. And I would love to offer you guys a free strategy session. And we can, you know, talk about what we've talked about here and how do you actually put that into practice and implement it into your life. We talked a lot about the principle, but then putting it into practice in your own life, sometimes, you know, it can be a unique situation. So all you need to do is put in that you heard in the contact page, you know, your name and email, and just let me know that you heard me on Lorraine's show, and then we'll set up some time to meet and have coffee virtually, of course, for 60 minutes and and then it's all about coffee now.
Well, thank you, Loretta. That's so kind and generous of you. So if you have any questions out there about my show, don't hesitate to get a hold of LorraineHoving.com. And I can also get you in contact with Loretta. And also online, I have Loretta and I are in a new book called Life Boost. And we each have a chapter in that book. And I'm offering that free, a free chapter if you go online. So that's a great deal. So I want to thank Loretta for being here today. This has been insightful. It's not an easy topic to talk about, but you've given us some real nuggets with the five gratitudes. And then, plus the bonus is five gratitudes, maybe write, sit down and write five gratitudes about your husband, who actually is right here with you right now, or somebody that you're having a difficulty with, and it will change your perspective. So I will see you back here next week with Loretta. And remember out there, it is never, ever too late to lose weight. It is never too late to sit down and write gratitudes. Start the practice today. It is never too late to go after your dreams. It is never, ever too late to live a life of purpose. It is just never too late, ever. We will see you back here next week, and I can hardly wait to talk to Loretta next time. Bye, Loretta.
Bye. Thank you.
You're welcome.